Welcome to the Grace Hour, the live international talk radio ministry of Greater Grace Church in Baltimore, Maryland. You can join us on the air today by calling 1-800-338-7060 or 410-483-3700 from outside of the United States. Now, here is our host.
And welcome, friends, to this edition of the Grace Hour, and welcome to our first live broadcast of the year 2022. Great to be with you, friends, on this Tuesday afternoon. We know that yesterday, of course, was the celebration of the New Year's Day here at the Greater Grace World Outreach, which is why we were not live. I think many of you were listening to the tape message that was prepared for you. Hope you enjoyed that. But we're back with you live in the studio today. And looking forward to having you join us. Following our devotional message today, we'll open those phone lines and very interested to hear your thoughts as we begin the start of a new year and a new theme all week long in the Grace Hour, which is consistent with the beginning of a new year. It's entitled, All Things Are New in Christ. And we're looking forward to sharing those thoughts along the lines of that theme with you, our listeners today, and then, of course, inviting you to join us. And you can do so simply by picking up a phone, dialing one of the following numbers, 800-338-7060. That is the toll-free number. And the local number is 410-483-3700. Again, when those phone lines are open, pick up that phone, give us a call, join us live, and be one of the first to join us in the new calendar year of 2022 right here on the Grace Hour. We'd like to welcome those of you that are tuning in and listening locally on our local station right here in Baltimore, WRBS. Thank you for joining us today and hope that we'll hear from some of you and those of you that are listening live on the internet at gracehour.org, Facebook Live, YouTube Live. You folks are both listening and watching, and you're brought right here into the studio with us. We appreciate that as well. Looking forward to hearing from many of you as we start a brand new week and a brand new year of broadcasting live right here on the Grace Hour. And this is such an encouraging theme because, you know, we could easily say, wait a minute, didn't all things become new when I accepted Christ as my Savior in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17? The answer is yes. But the great thing about this relationship that we have with Christ is that every moment is new. Every hour is new. Every day is new. And we're excited about that. And we're looking at the new things that God is going to do throughout this new year, both in your lives and in ours as well. We have a tremendous expectation from God as we begin a new year of broadcasting live right here in the Grace Hour. And again, we're thrilled to be able to kick it off with you joining us live. Joining me in the studio today is Pastor Jason Moore. He's going to bring forth the first live devotional in 2022.
Okay, no pressure.
No pressure. No pressure.
All of a sudden, I feel this pressure. Thanks, Pastor Love. What a privilege it is to be speaking to our listening audience, and happy new year. Blessed new year. You know, I spoke with one brother recently, like, what's so happy about this next year? And it's because we our joy and our expectations in the Lord. And thank you, Lord, for that. So just thinking about this theme about newness, and I love what you just said, like there's new mercies, and we can know this maybe theoretically, but God is always bringing us into a place of relationship. He's always bringing us into a place of actuality. And that's why there's no potential in God. It's only actual, because he cannot be any greater or less than who he is today. His intensity or his love and care towards us is the maximum intensity that it could be. Even does not depend on our performance. He is who he is in all circumstances and in all responses. But how we experience this is up to us, if we could say, our response to God, our expectation, our mind renewal. These are things that help us to engage and really experience our faith. Because theoretical, being just knowledge alone, is not enough. And this is why newness is really, we must step into newness, let go of what we think we know in 1 Corinthians 8:2. We know nothing as we ought to know it. And what does that really mean? It means the depth of newness is so much greater than the natural mind could even comprehend. What is the depth of newness? Well, Romans 11:33, it's past finding out. We'll be spiritual archaeologists all the days of our life. And really, we will never come to the depth of his love. We'll never understand the maximum marvelous grace. We'll never understand the beauty of comfort, the Father of all comfort. And thank God for that, because really newness happens, that refreshment of Acts 3:19, when we step into the mystery. We step into the mystery. In this new year, God wants to bring you beyond what you think you know of him, what we think we have really maybe confirmed in our heart. Maybe you've been through trials and challenges, and we have gained experience. Thank you, Lord, for that experience. But God is saying, I'm not limited to the past. I'm not limited to your experience. I'm not even limited to the knowledge of what you think you know. And this is the beauty of a growing relationship and a renewal of our spirit. So in Matthew chapter 9, look with me if you would, in verse 17, we're seeing an interesting passage here. We look a couple verses up. It says, no one puts a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, for the patch pulls away from the garment and the tear is made worse. Nor do they put new wine into old wineskins, or else the wineskins break. The wine is spilled and the wineskins are ruined. But they put new wine into new wineskins and both are preserved. So the question is, how do we really enter into this newness? How is it that we can leave this me-centered philosophy? And it's everywhere. It's everywhere, this me-centered philosophy, this old wineskin, where we relate to God based on our feelings. We relate to God based on our experience. We relate to God based on our natural understanding. This is all old wineskins. And the new wine, which speaks of the Holy Spirit, but even just naturally, wine itself, when it's fresh and fermented, it will break through the old crusty part of the wineskin, and it will not be able to handle the newness of wine. We need the supernatural work of God to meet the supernatural expectation of God. So that old wineskin, the me-centered philosophy, the myopic mindset of me, I look to me, then God. God says, you'll never experience newness that way. Never. We must look away unto him, behold him, hear him, trust him, be vulnerable to him, and then we're able to experience a true understanding of who we are in him. And that's when newness happens. Maybe my situation doesn't change, but we change. Maybe the trial doesn't necessarily change, but we begin to have fruitfulness and gain God's purpose in the trial. Isaiah 43 tells us this in verse 18 and 19, do not remember the former things. Do not even consider the things of old. And I feel like this is a very important step. We also see this in Philippians 3:13, that to let go of the old is very difficult because it's what we know. It's what we know. The chronic issue, the chronic sin, the chronic pain, the chronic maybe abuse or something in our past is just right there as a burr in our saddle. God is saying here, do not consider or remember. And this is what happens when we grab a hold of something new. It begins to replace the old. We're able to let go of the wires and say, I cannot fix myself. I cannot fix you. You cannot fix me. And God never said that he would fix us. But what he did say is he would heal us. He would heal us emotionally. He would heal us physically. He would heal us mentally. And there's so much mental illness that we are seeing in our society today because of the response to the day and age we're living in. If we must respond in newness and look away unto the Lord, we must step into the mystery, Romans 11:33, the mystery of grace, scandalous grace, we could say, the extravagant love that God loves us extravagantly. And we don't understand it, but God says, I've not called you to understand it. I've called you to believe it. And that's another way to enter into newness. We're so wired to understand God and try to figure it out and ask him a million questions. I'm always amazed at Job and all the questions he asked God. I think it was over 10 questions, and he responded with over 60. Isn't that just like us? And we would dare say that we would be the same way. And God is saying, stop trying to analyze me. Stop trying to figure me out. Just when you figure it out, I want to bring you in a new place. And this is what verse 19 is all about. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. He'll go beyond the natural understanding. It's like when Peter walked in the water. There was no natural way to really describe except that God defies logic. He goes beyond, I mean, logic is beautiful. Reasoning is beautiful. Deductive reasoning, so valuable. Critical thinking, so valuable. But God says, I must go beyond and bring you into a place of newness, a new way to relate to me, a new way to relate in faith, a new way to step out saying, with God, nothing is impossible, Luke 1:37. And John 14:12, Jesus said, you will do greater works than I because of the authority of my Father. Greater as in quantity. Let's believe that today in the new year. So God is saying newness, new expectations, a new response, a new knowledge. Oftentimes, we revert back to our small-mindedness. We talk about our sin. We talk about the past. We talk about why things don't work. Who's talking with a new language today? Who's talking in the language of love? Who's talking in the language of grace? Who's talking reconciliation today? Who's talking forgiveness? Who's talking the life of Christ in the face of failure? This is how we step out of our complicated, chaotic messes, and we say, God, it's you alone. Without you, I can do nothing. Well, we see some excellent verses here. Ephesians 2:15, the new man is the only way we experience peace. The new man in newness, never been used, never old. The defiled is defiled no longer, because of the sanctity of grace, the sanctity of the blood of Christ that purges us from our dead works, that renews our thinking, that renews and removes the stain of sin. It's so beautiful to be released into this newness, to let go of the harassing hurt, and say, God, I give you my ashes, and you give me your beautifulness. It's a way to live. It's a way to live. It's the only way to live. Otherwise, we limit God. We make God into our own image, and we have canned statements that have no life, and we just kind of fake it. And God is saying, the only way forward is death to yourself so that I can resurrect you in newness. That's the answer for sin today. It's not trying not to sin. We'll sin even worse. It's allowing and surrendering to the newness of God, and God puts in new appetites, a new mind. He rewires you and gives you new expectation. He gives you new faith as he replaces our limited short-sightedness with the faith of his son, Jesus Christ. Ephesians 4:24, put on the new man, which is created in perfection. What a way to live today. Put on this new man, putting it on, saying, Lord, I decide to put on the whole armor and to engage and to believe and to go beyond this me-centered philosophy. I don't know about you. It's like I see this all over my life. I want to have less of me and more of him in John 3:30. Not to relate based on my feelings, like, God, why aren't you answering my prayer? Or why aren't you following my plan? Or why do I feel depressed today? It's like we need to jump out of that and say, Lord, you are my contentment. You are my peace. You are, John 14:27, you are my everything. And that decision and the ignoring and the deflecting and the detachment, these are all ways to step into newness, not relating to the old. Notice this in Hebrews 8:13, amazing. The new covenant was given. I want to read this verse. So the old one is obsolete. How much of our lives and thinking is obsolete? Well, if we're not living in the finished work, we're living in an obsolete or a degenerate or a distorted view. But in Hebrews is an incredible book, 8:13, it says this, in him he says, a new covenant he has made, the first one obsolete. Now what is becoming obsolete and growing old is already vanished away. How much of this thought, this old way of thinking, just brings us with a greater understanding of our sin? God is saying, look away and look unto me, and I will regenerate you. I will sanctify you. I will renew you. I will refresh you in my presence. And the naggingness of the past or sin will vanish away. The law, we won't be legalistic Christians, we will be faith rest Christians. We'll leave the crystallization, the stagnation, and we'll enter into engagement, relationship, joy, peace, real peace. I was reading with my son today, Proverbs chapter 1, verse 33, he who hears me will dwell in peace. There's newness right there. There's newness right there. God's saying, are you listening to my new mindset? The scriptures will always bring you into a place of newness and give you the joy of the Lord in your difficulty. Actually, you'll have, in relationships, the complications of relationships, the he said, she said, what she's not doing, what he's not doing, all the things that we deserve, this entitlement, this me-centered philosophy is just old. Isaiah 64:6, it's filthy. It's there's nothing good in it. And we can say, you know what? Today, this person's a gift in my life. Today, I've never lived this moment before. I've never been in this time in history. It's a brand new day, and we're going to live with the new mercies of God, and he's going to give us new eyes, new ears, new hearts, a new way of thinking. I think of just missions this next year. What could God do? We had an amazing New Year's service here. And don't you love hearing the mission that is so impossible by sight? And God is saying, I'm going to do it. I want you to just trust me, to believe me, to step into the mystery, step into the limitlessness of God, to step into, put on his perfection. Immediately, we begin to try to analyze it. How can this happen? Or What can I do to help God? Or I don't deserve it. And we start to go into this analyzation, and analyzing is good for problem solving, but it's not good for steps of faith. We just are led by the Spirit, and He leads us into newness, new love, new forgiveness, new peace, a new language, a new way of relating to ourselves. And the old wineskins, what happens? We don't try to fix them. We don't try to patch them. We don't try to make the old man look good. But instead, what are we doing? We are saying, God, make me new. Make me brand new. Make me who you've said that I am in you. So today, just to encourage our hearts today, the old is gone in 2 Corinthians 5:17. We certainly may have consequences from bad decisions, but God says, I'll give you new mercies for those consequences. I'll show you new purposes. I'll show you a new way. I'll make what's impossible possible. I'll make rivers in the desert, roads in the wilderness. Pioneering, I will make I'll make you walk on water this year. How many of us want to walk on water in 2022, spiritually speaking? Lord, and notice that God, God changed the dynamic of the water. And He says, I'm going to support you. I'm going to hold you up. I'm going to hold you up in your sickness. I'm going to hold you up in your financial situation. I'm going to hold you up in your family situation. I was talking with another family about some family members that are not walking with God right now and how broken they are, thinking about them. God wants to do a new thing in families, and He will do it. 21:5 of Revelations, He will make it happen His way, His timing, His beautiful way of doing things is so differently than us. So today, just step into newness wherever you are. Step into a new place with God. Surrender your ashes, and He'll give you something beautiful. And thank you, Jesus. He's always giving us something beautiful because it's from Himself. Amen.
And amen. Great thoughts to get us started, friends, on the first live broadcast of the new calendar year 2022. And what a great theme. All things are new in Christ. No matter what your challenges, difficulties were yesterday, last night, an hour ago, all things can be new. Why? Well, because God promises those new mercies, and He promises and so desires to do a new thing in each one of our lives. So look to Him. Continue to believe Him. Let Him build on your faith. Let Him, again, pick up right where He left off at the end of 2021. And I know there are many that would probably say, I'm glad that year's in the rearview mirror. But yet, God did something. God did a work. God was active. He changed you. His work never ends. Let Him continue to do that work. Let Him do a new thing in your life in 2022. You're listening live to the Grace Hour, friends, and we want to continue the conversation in our studio. We're going to do that, and we want to invite you to join us. So pick up that phone and join us live simply by dialing one of these numbers toll-free in all of North America. Wherever you are, Canada, United States, you could be up in the Yukon, as far north as we could even imagine, and you could join us live. This telephone number, 800-338-7060. Again, that is the toll-free number in both Canada and the United States, 800-338-7060. And here locally, in the greater Baltimore area, 410-483-3700. And, of course, throughout the continental United States, you can dial the toll-free number or the local number. Those of you overseas, 410-483-3700. Fill up the lines. Let's hear from you. Who's going to be our first caller of 2022? We hope it's you. Go to your phones right away. You know, we're not like some radio broadcasts, Pastor Jason, where we offer you some kind of a prize. It's just a privilege if you, again, join us as our first caller of 2022, and you can make your contribution to the broadcast by sharing what's on your heart, or perhaps even a testimony in relationship to what's new or what God is doing new in your life. Karen Lewis, Pastor Jim up in Peabody, Massachusetts, appreciated the message today. She said, amen, thank you. And Heather said, amen. And Evie Santiago says, wow, what a good word. Great to hear from you, Evie, I believe, down in Florida. And we hope that, we hope it's a little warmer where you are than it is here. Finally, we got some winter.
Wow.
It showed up in Baltimore. A few inches of snow and a little bit of ice. It's all being cleared away. And I imagine in a matter of a day or two, it'll all be gone. But
yes.
It was nice to see, you know, the area coated with a little bit of snow.
Yeah, it makes everything look clean and beautiful.
For a little while.
my son and I were out making an ice snowman. It was a lot of fun, just freezing, but also just enjoying the beauty of the storm. But, you know, Pastor Love, don't you think familiarity is a real one of those things that always drags the bones and the oldness of something? Like, I think in relationships, it's so easy to know people after the flesh and their sin. And it's a real decision to say, hey, no, today is brand new. I'm not going to look at, I mean, because naturally speaking, we're focused on people's, just the way people respond, and maybe we have expectations and they're not met. And God's like saying, listen, it's a mystery. I mean, it's a mystery to step into this place with me, have my eyes, my ears. And that's something I think we're constantly learning every day, yeah. Every day.
I mean, when you look at those two words, familiarity, faith, in a dictionary, they're very close to each other. And you can say the same thing about life. You can become very familiar. But if your mind is being renewed, and someone may ask the question, well, practically speaking, how are all things new in my life? Well, your mind is being renewed and can be renewed on a very consistent basis in Romans chapter 12, verse 2. You can be renewed in the spirit of your mind in Ephesians 4:23. And this is how it happens. That freshness, that newness that everybody longs for, is within the realm of possibility and potential for all believers. We just have to, by faith, look for it. And I don't mean that in terms of human effort or good or any kind of merit on our part. Just be expecting it. And when opportunity presents itself to have that happen, the renewing of our minds, the renewing of our spirit of our minds, take full advantage of it. And that newness will become yours. Well, friends, we're going to wrap up the first half hour. That went by very quickly, just like the year has, just like our lives are. But we'll be back in just a couple of moments to start the second half of today's Grace Hour broadcast. So please stay with us and join us if you can. We're back with you live at gracehour.org and Facebook Live, YouTube Live. A lot of the folks are looking at us and watching us on Facebook Live and YouTube Live. We appreciate that very much. Many of you are even across the other side of the world. And speaking of the other side of the world, Pastor Schaller has made his way over to the country of Finland. So be praying for him and his travels and the meetings that he will be having with the believers in that part of the world. Keep him in your prayers for safe traveling and, no roadblocks, no obstacles. And if there are any obstacles, may you, Lord, turn them into opportunities to proclaim the gospel and to encourage your people. So bless Pastor Schaller as he travels throughout Scandinavia in the next week or so. And Mary has asked a good question, Pastor Jason. That question is, how do you avoid familiarity?
Boy, that's a loaded question and worth our time, I think. Again, I think we love it when things are familiar. They're safe, maybe. They're predictable. There are things that we know. I think this is why we don't grow, because we kind of stay in the same place because it's comfort for us. But in Christ, he is always leading us to himself. And I think this is how we avoid familiarity, is we're close to him. We're near him. We're Ephesians 4:24, we're putting on him. And we are putting us second. We are second. And I think more often than not, our the way we relate to things is really so me-centered. Like, how can God answer my prayer? How can God meet my provision? How can God bless me? And those are not wrong things, but they're just not the primary thing. The primary thing is, God, how can I understand your will? And I want to step into that place of seeking you, engaging you. Like Pastor Schaller said recently, like to take hold of him, take hold of him. So to avoid familiarity, I would just say is to say, God, I don't know anything as I ought to, so I want to learn it again. Teach me again. Make me as a little child. And I think in relationships, Pastor Love, this is a real challenge because we must really have that helmet of salvation, that helmet of newness, our eyes fixed, and to not just have this, experience is good, but what if it's the bad experience? You know, it needs to be replaced with a divine experience. And I don't know, we could say a lot more about that.
No doubt. But I think you really nailed it. Sometimes it's a matter of just getting up and getting off the couch. We're all familiar with the phrase, you know, the couch potatoes. Well, the New Testament equivalent might be, for the disciples, the boat potatoes. They stayed in the boat. And, you know, plenty of justification as to why they should stay in the boat. There's a storm out there. You leave that boat, you risk your life. Peter decides, you know, I don't want to be a boat potato. I'd like to step out of that boat. I want to take that step of faith. And that's what we all need to be challenged with when we face a new year. Yes, it's so easy to stay where we are. It's so comfortable because we've found our comfort zone. Step out of it.
Yeah.
Step away from it, because again, that small step from familiarity to faith can do great things in our lives. And, you know, whatever it might be, we'll just give a few illustrations. It may be that this year, you know, by God's grace and praying and believing that this pandemic will be behind us, I'm going to take a trip to another country. It may be that, you know, I'm going to make a decision because God has blessed me financially. I'm going to support missionaries in some part of the globe. These are the kinds of steps. You know, I'm going to step up in my local church. I haven't made myself available to serve in any capacity, but I'm going to take that step of faith. Maybe that Bible study that you're thinking about starting with your family, with your neighbors, at the workplace, you finally say, I'm going to take that step of faith. I'm going to do that. Excellent. Step out of it. Just, you know, step away from the couch. Get out of your boat. You know, you could say, yeah, but Peter, he sank. Yeah, but, you know, he also walked on water. For how long? We don't know for sure. But can any of the other disciples say that? No. Peter had a story to tell.
I love this. Just start where you are. Maybe you don't have a lot in your hands, but you have something, you know. There's so many excuses, and God's like, you have me. You know, I think why sin is such a magnet for all of us, really, is because we are living in the oldness of something. Maybe, you know, I look at our world, and so many are under-challenged, underdeveloped. Do you ever look at a kid that's under-challenged? I mean, I know, looking at my son, he loves to be challenged. He doesn't know that, but his mind is racing. So it's like when he's got something to sink his teeth in mentally, he is thriving. You know, he loves to make paper airplanes. I mean, he got this book, How to Make like All These Different Airplanes and All These Different Folds. And it's very complicated. I had to like study it myself. But he's like right into it. An hour goes by, 2 hours goes by. So it's like maybe God is not maybe, but God is wanting to move us out of our comfort zone and into a new place. And this is where new joy, new faith, you know, a new element of stubbornness. How about that? Like, stubbornness is a good word in the sense of stubborn faith. Like, let's believe it till it happens. Let's pray it till it happens. Let's just confess it until it's a reality. This is such a way to live. Like, let's get feisty a little bit. That's new feistiness.
Yeah. Amen. You can join us, friends. I don't believe we're having any technical difficulties. I think we were having some internet problems earlier in the day. I think we have solved them. So if you have been trying to get a hold of us but unable to get through, we want to encourage you to try again. Take that step of faith and join us. 800-338-7060, that is the toll-free number anywhere in North America, and locally 410-483-3700. Just to share the vision of 2022 with our listeners, Pastor Schiavelli shared it last week, and Pastor Schaller has reiterated it again through email. And here's a little bit of that vision of 2022, to reach 12 more countries, including Colombia, Namibia, Singapore, to send out 30 missionaries from this one local assembly here in Baltimore, including people like the Brockmeyers, the Plunkets, the Hillingas, start 70 more churches worldwide, a recovery program where we will see 100 men and women delivered from addictions, and for people to fall in love with their Bibles and one another, and to see our Bible college students, student leaders raised up, and the start, the onset of a brand new Bible college semester here at the end of January at MBCNS. What a great vision. Now, some people say, well, that's very aggressive. That's a little bit over the top. Hey, we're not asking one person to do this or to do that. We're addressing the entire body of Christ. And as we address the body of Christ, the corporate body of Christ, we'll see a vision like this come to pass. So again, you don't have to say, I can't do all of that. God doesn't expect you to. Mm. But he may challenge you by faith to do what you can to help that vision corporately come to pass. Well, let's go to the phones. Our dear, dear friend, Lise, is joining us from Montreal. Lise, welcome to the program.
Thank you. Happy New Year, Pastor Love.
Happy New Year, Pastor
Jason.
Hello.
It's very fantastic. Did I lose the race, or am I the first one?
You are the first one. Congratulations.
Yay!
The prize for you, Lise, is that you can call anytime you want.
Thank you. That's enough. My Pastor Jason, actually, I know I have I don't know if I could say that in English, the big slant when I hear these days, when I hear the word, because I'm always thinking about my trip to Baltimore. And I, you know, when you were saying that, familiarity, we have a tendency to remain comfortable on our couch. And it's exactly, it's like, it's a challenge to decide to take the road for it's going to be maybe at least 13 hours for me. So, God is good. And also, I had another topic. Well, not another topic. It's in the same subject, because we took the class, Hebrew class, with Pastor James last semester. Mm-hmm. And it was not my first time to take Hebrew. I took it with Pastor Schaller. But, I understand, they were talking about Kathy Ryan being tired 39 years in Bible school. Of course, why not? I learned again this year about Hebrew. I got a totally new perspective on that letter. It's a hard one, I find. It's not hard, but someone has to explain it very clear. Well, actually, it's because of many times. But the thing I was thinking about was about where they talk about the witnesses. And I'm just looking for the... We are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. It's in the Hebrew 14, probably. Oh, no, the
Hebrews
beginning
12.
Of chapter 12.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it says, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses. Mm-hmm. And I think I had a revelation, I mean, personal revelation. Maybe you guys already know about that. But it's like you guys in Baltimore, you are responsible, or, it, you know, because of you guys, you know, I look at you and you witness to me like the greatness of God is power for your lives of faith, because I have a small idea how much you guys, each of the pastors in Baltimore, the body members, you walk by faith, you know, I mean, and that is what is a witness to me about God, you know. You witness God to me, and it's going to help me just take the road and just drive down to Baltimore, you know. Mm. And that's what I want. Because, you know, many times you have in the books, you know, this idea of a big stadium with a lot of people, like, clapping their hands for you. But finally, we think it may be not that idea. This idea is that these guys they just mentioned in chapter 11, mm. they are witnessing to us about the greatness of God, you know?
Yes.
And that makes us go ahead.
That's yet right.
Go forward with God. Well, I don't know what you think.
No, no, you you're right. I think you're right. Clearly, it does make a reference to all of the heroes of faith that are spoken of in the 11th chapter of the book of Hebrews. But I think you could also include, as you said, those witnesses that are before us today, whose lives we can look at and find courage and strength from. No question about it. Whatever witnesses will allow us and enable us to run this race in such a way that we win the prize, those are good witnesses, and we should be reminded of them often.
Yeah. A beautiful... beautiful thing.
Yeah.
Like I see in front of me my library with all the beautiful Christian biographies, you know, like, I mean, these people I read, I often think about them, you know?
Sure.
There was a family, they went to Amazonie, where in Brazil, you know, this
yeah,
big
the Amazon.
River?
Yes.
The Amazon, yeah. So, I mean, they had prepared everything for their trip, everything, like even the machine to make the photocopies when she would send the newsletters, you know, they had thought about all the details they needed to have this life in the middle of the jungle, you know.
Yes.
And during the trip, the boats they were, you know, on the river they took, the boats they all went down, and they lost absolutely everything, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And they went on, and they went on, and they had beautiful years over there in Amazon, in this region, you know?
Amazing.
And I mean, I think about that family, but I also think about, you know, all the big names, like, I have, you know, like the biography of, this man from England, you know, who had the orphans, what's his name, all the orphans, he had no money, and the bread would come
Mueller.
In front of the Mueller. Yeah, George Mueller.
Yes.
You know, like all these men, all these women, you know, like, wow.
Well, Lise,
they are witnesses.
They are, and you need to be reminded of this as well. You're one of those witnesses.
Mm.
Oh, you are. Nice. You are a witness to me. You're a witness to many that are listening today in the Grace Hour. When I think of you and your faith, I'm deeply encouraged.
Thank you, Pastor Love.
It's true. Yes. And I think I speak for a lot of people too. At least
That's so nice.
I think I do.
Yes. Yes. It's true.
It's true. There isn't anyone who knows you that when your name is mentioned or brought up that doesn't just light up and have a smile on their face, because you pour courage into our hearts, and you're one of those great witnesses as well.
And you know how to build up someone, Pastor Love. I think, I think I'm going to call often.
Hey, thank you so much for the call, and Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year. Thank you.
God bless you.
Bye-bye.
Bye. 800-338-7060 is the toll-free number. Locally, it's 410-483-3700. And another precious soul that's been trying to reach us, another great witness of the faith, Suzette, joining us right here from Baltimore. Welcome.
Funny, Pastor Love. Thank you for that encouragement. And you're so right about Lisa. You're speaking the voice of the people. You know, we do, you know, enjoy so much to hear her testimony, her delight, her love for the Lord and love for the body. And it's good to hear her when she calls, you know.
Amen.
And thank you, too, for that, so that we're not boat potato people, you know. Get out the boat, you
yep.
know. Go ahead.
Amen.
You know. And give it a shot. What do we have to lose, Pastor? Mm. What do we have to lose?
Nothing, you know? And there's so much to gain, right?
Absolutely. You know, let's go for it. And, you know, one of the things that I have an expectation of the Lord for this year is to, you know, we can't measure the impact of our witness. No, it's not really being a greater witness, yet it is. It's like, Lord, just to, you know, to take out and those steps of faith. And that's what I was thinking about when Pastor was giving a devotional this morning, Pastor Jay, I mean earlier, you know, and just how, you know, one of the ways that we do, you know, like the sister that called up or texted about familiarity is that, you know, we look away, you know, from what was, you know, and we just, that's so fresh and so new. And like you said about the Philippians, we press on, you know, towards the mark. So, you know, one of the verses that we get from Philippians, I mean, see from Hebrews as well, is look away unto Jesus. You know, we look away, the author and finisher of our faith for the joy that was set before him. Come on now. You know, so that was my comment.
Beautiful. We're glad that you pressed on and made it to the Grace Hour today. And thank you so much, Suzette. I mean, you're one of those champions of the faith. You
yes.
have battled through some incredible, incredible physical challenges, a lot of suffering. And yet here you are edifying other believers and encouraging us here in the Grace Hour. You are in that cloud of witnesses.
Yes.
Thank you. It's such a privilege to be a part of the body of Christ, of the kingdom of God, and us functioning in that. And Pastor Jay, you share one of my favorite verses that, you know, was at one time, it was a particular point in time, it was a verse for my heart. And then it became a life verse for me, which is like, you know, Isaiah, the verse in Isaiah 43:9, you know, and just thinking about, hey, look, you know, I was like, He's going to give us a witness. He's going to do what he needs to do for us, for our life, so that we can be encouraged in him, you know, and it's like he's doing a new thing. And thinking about that in relationship to 1 Corinthians 13, how love is, you know, love is patient, love is kind, is the right now, you know, it's the new thing that he's refreshing to our hearts and our life for now. So let's go for it.
Amen. Suzette, just to echo what Pastor Love is saying, just so good to see you and Emmanuel recently in church, and just thinking of your life and your steps of faith, your great love and care. I think of how much of an edifier you are. As you were talking, I thought, you know, what is edification? Edification is someone that initiates newness. You're just throwing out or projecting value, God's value, God's care on people. That's what you do. And, you know, you're not consumed with your limitations. It's very easy. We all could maybe, you know, walk by sight. But when that happens, it's all old. It's just all excuses. It's all reasons to quit. But when we walk in wonder, I thought of that. 2 Corinthians 5:7, the NLT version, it says, do not walk by what you can understand, but walk in wonder. This is when things really take on a new purpose. And thank you for you, Suzette.
Thank you. Bless you, Pastor. You're cool. Thank you. Oh, yeah. I love your podcast. I'm just throwing that out.
Oh.
I listen to you when I can as well. And, you know, it was such a blessing to, I saw or listened to one, you know, from yesterday. But, you know, hey, It's all about going forward. That's all that we know.
That's the only direction we care about.
Amen. Love you both. God bless you.
Thank you
for great
Suzette.
Power.
God bless you.
2022. Hallelujah.
Amen. Bye. Amen. Thanks for the call. 800-338-7060. And we do have plenty of time to take your call, so don't hesitate. Oh, we were just going to take Aretha's call, and she's disappeared from our screen. Aretha, if you're listening, give us a call back quickly. We'll get to your call right away.
What will God do in 22? That's a fun little...
Yeah, it's a great question.
I love this initiating newness. I mean, I think you've brought this up many times. You know, they say this about insanity is doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. So sometimes we have to step, well, not sometimes, we need to step out and say, God, I'm just going to receive from you new hunger, a new mindset. I'm going to decide in my heart to say no to this and yes to that, to lay aside what is good and take a hold of what is great. And I love this in 2 Corinthians 5:7, to walk in wonder. I think we can lose our wonder, our amazement. Satan's always trying to steal our amazement. Maybe we're walking forward in 2022 with our thinking about 2021, and there's things to learn, but also, what will God do in 22? Like, he's going to do John 14:12, right? Many things that he's prepared.
Amen. Let's go up to Brooklyn, New York, our good friend, Pastor John Cooper. Pastor Cooper, thanks for joining us on the Grace Hour, sir. Go right ahead.
Pastor Love, Pastor Jason, I came in a little after you started, and it's just great. I'm just stirred up by this talk of the witnesses that we have that are encouraging us to move forward in the plan and the purpose of God. And first of all, I want to just share Pastor Schaller stopped in Brooklyn on his way to Finland, and that was just a real treat, honor. That Pastor Schaller, the senior pastor of the Greater Grace World Outreach, would stop by to our Brooklyn church and share, open the book, and we prayed, we laughed, and wow, it's a great way to start the year. I was thinking of, you know, how those we have living epistles before us in Hebrews 13:7-17, which says, obey them and have the rule over you. I think of that word, I think it's prohistomai, those that stand before you as an example. And the power of leadership, when we're not familiar, the encouragement of you know, the imparted word of God, where we go from faith, out from faith into faith, where faithers faithing, living by faith, moving forward in the will and the plan and the purpose of God, and how we even, Hebrews 10:24, how we provoke, stimulate one another in the sphere of God's love, to not forsake the assembling of ourselves, because we see the beauty and the glory of the Lord being in the midst of us, and in our fellowship and worship and praise and opening the book. I could still hear Pastor Stevens saying, don't quit. these are like in our frame of reference, in our spirit, that kind of investment, our late Pastor Moses, and all of the categories of the Word of God prepare us for the present with a hope that is rooted in Christ for our future. I'm just fired up listening, looking at you gentlemen on Grace Hour, and seeing that we are still here, and you are witnesses of the faithfulness of God. So just grateful for the leaders, the pastors in the local assemblies, Pastor Johnson. You know, we have encouragers, and we encourage the encouragers, and the body just continues to be edified and mobilized in moving forward. So I just want to share gratitude attitude.
Beautiful. Just so great. I'm glad you brought up those verses too, in Hebrews 13:7-17. This has been a real point of controversy in the church at large worldwide today, because people want to magnify the failures of those in positions of leadership. They want to, if they find out that they've sinned or stumbled or have been less than faithful, they believe that, therein lies justification for anyone to no longer have to listen to those that are leading the church today. But come on, if someone tries to tell you or I that, you know, there's no bona fide leadership in the Church of Jesus Christ today, that's foolishness. There are those that, out of a pure heart, out of a sincere heart and mind, follow after God and encourage other believers to follow their example. And there will always be godly examples for us to follow. Make no mistake about it. So again, we hear enough about the failures of those in positions of leadership. We're aware of it. We know it happens. They have feet of clay. We understand that. But we can also find the faithful in the midst of even those that fail. And we can have great examples before us. And I'm glad you pointed that out, Pastor. Thanks so much.
Amen. It's important. That's why the whole purpose in our growth and maturity is Hebrews 13:9, having our hearts established in grace.
Yes.
And Pastor Love, Pastor Shallow was sharing last night, I think it was from Micah, where he said, love mercy. Like, love mercy. When we love mercy, you know, he said, we're working on that. We were, you know, but our orientation is to the grace and mercy of God. And if it was not for the grace of God, the mercy of God, who, if he were to mark iniquity, who would stand? And we do have, you know, we know we're taught, well taught, in the light of balance and accountability and so forth. But praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
But this premise that we have.
It's because of those mercies that we are not consumed.
Yes.
Thank you, Pastor Cooper.
Thank you, gentlemen. God bless you. Happy New Year. Happy New You.
Amen. Amen.
Happy New Year. That's good.
Hey, we have just enough time to squeeze Aretha's call in. Aretha, can you do 30 seconds?
Yes, God, Pastor Love and Pastor Jason. Oh, blessed New Year to both of you, man. You don't know how prayerful you are this morning already.
Good.
And I need your prayer. Oh, yeah. You are on my prayer list, Pastor Love. And Pastor Jason from Pastor Shalom, come right down. And I need your prayers, you know, as my body get older, but I'm a fighter. I never give up. Never give up. One of my prayer warriors went home with Jesus just a few days ago from St. Croix. When before she died, she couldn't wait to go and meet Jesus. She was in so much pain. Mm. And that's a glorious testimony. Oh, yes. That's
Ten seconds, yeah. Aretha.
Love you. Love you. Enjoy your rest of the day. Love you.
You're in our prayers, dear. You know we love you.
Yeah.
God bless you. Friends, we're out of time. Thanks, Pastor Jason, for joining us today. We'll be back tomorrow for the next live edition of the Grace Hour, friends. That's coming up, well, less than 24 hours. We hope you'll join us then. Until then, may God bless you and continue to make all things new.
Thanks for listening to The Grace Hour. Our live program airs weekdays at 1 p.m. Eastern Time. Grace Hour is a ministry of the Greater Grace Church. You are invited to visit Greater Grace at 6025 Moravia Park Drive, Baltimore, Maryland, 21206. For more information, go to gracehour.org or call 1-800-338-7060.